that's what the judgment works in the right.
See, I told you the other day, right, about Anne Frank and how her house is now a very important monument over there. And where did Anne Frank go into hiding? Right? So that is known as the secret annex. So this is, you know, like, yes, yeah, so we just see here, right? Okay. So you can just watch this video. I've shared one yesterday also, and see here how they have made her house where she lived. It is now as a museum, and people, they come and see that how they lived in such a place for so many years, right? So for more than 2 years, they were in hiding, okay? And this house is there, okay, right? So yeah, you people are there, very aware of what things are there on the nurse's diary, and which we all have read an extract from, right? So you can just have a look at this when you have time, and you just try to imagine that how it must have been so difficult for to live in hiding, and you know, as I told you, that constant fear of death and that constant fear of being taken. Okay, right. So let me see the students who are entering. So I just shown you a little clip here, and if you want, I can just share it in the group also, this video. So you have an idea, like, okay, the things that you can easily find about Anne Frank and about her life. Okay, right. Now, let's come to the writing skill that we are going to discuss. All of you, can you just keep your notebooks ready? Yeah, can I see your notebooks? Yes. So we're going to start with paragraph writing today. And a very important part of paragraph writing that we are going to discuss is data interpretation. I have discussed with you, I have sent a few examples for you all also, right? So we have, you know, like, you have your data interpretation, you have your, what you can say, descriptive paragraphs also, right? You might have narrative paragraphs. So all these kind of paragraphs, they can be asked from you. And yes, you will be given a verbal visual input from which you can take your guidelines and do your writing skill. So let us do one example today. Like, here, can you see the blackboard behind me? Can you see the blackboard, all of you? Yes, is it visible? Okay, right. So what is it? Yes, sir. Thank you, Harshit. Yeah, thank you. Okay, for letting me know. So what is it about here? So you've got an idea that what we are going to, what is it that we are going to discuss? It is paragraph writing, and it is data interpretation. So can you hear me? I think so. This length of the mic is going to allow me. Okay, so paragraph writing, data interpretation. Yeah. What is data interpretation? Data, any kind of data that is given to us, any kind of information that is given to us, right? So it can be, like, as I have told you, it could be a pie chart, it could be a bar graph, right? It could be a picture which is given to you. And you have to understand and analyze it. So in a way, what are we going to do in data interpretation? Statistics would be provided to you, right? And those statistics, what are you going to do? You are going to analyze and understand them, right? What is that information? What is it about, right? And after that, you will be giving your conclusion, your observations, okay? Here, I want you to use more of the information that is given. So when we write the paragraph, see here, I have made this graph, right? It is showing the dropout rate of boys and girls from schools, right? So this is a very rough depiction which I have shown you. I'll be sharing the pictures with you in the group, okay? And you will be writing those paragraphs in your notebook also, okay? Now, supposing here, this is a paragraph that you have to write. Now, if you look at this here, you will find that there are two linear graphs, right? And one is showing about the dropout rate of the boys, and the other is showing the dropout rate of the girls, right? Fine. And right, it could be, say, from 2001 to 2010. Or, right, so the information is of those 10 years. And what do we notice here? That there is an increase in the dropout, okay, gradually, right? You can say up till the year 2003, it was maybe the highest dropout rate of both boys and girls there, right here, the year 2004-05, which we're able to analyze, right? And then there's a steady decline. Okay, right? So what is this paragraph about? It is about, we'll be giving a heading to it. For all the writing skills, you have to give a heading, right? Yeah, so what could be the heading for this paragraph? What could be the heading? Yes, who's going to tell me? Will tell me? Yes. Now, let me see if my mic allows me to reach up to the blackboard. Yes, what is the heading that you're going to give? The dropout rate of, yes, boys and girls or the students from school, right? Clear? Now, what are you going to hear? Now, the given graph, it shows us the dropout rate of boys and girls from the school from the year, see, 2001 onwards. It is observed here that from the year 2001 to the year 2004, there was a rapid increase in the dropout rate of boys and girls from school, right? Then you can see that after the year 2004, the dropout rate of the boys declined, but even though the dropout rate of the girls had also declined, it was still more than the dropout rate of the boys. Clear? You can write this. Now we will try to understand what could be the causes of the dropout rate. What is dropout? Dropout means to stop going to school. Okay? Right. So yes, so where do you think this phenomenon or this kind of behavior would be common? Dropping out from school, where would it be more common? In the cities or in the rural areas? Where will it be more common? Yes? Where will it be? In the rural areas. Yes. So why do you think there would be a dropout rate? Why would there be more dropout rate here? What could be the reasons? The lack of transport facilities, right? Then it could, yes, that the schools are not nearby. Yes, so maybe in that area, in the village, that the school is not near and they have to go very far. Yes, so there is less transport. What else could be? Then as we notice here, the girls' dropout rate is still more than the boys. What could be the reasons for the more dropout rate of the girls as compared to the boys? Yes, the parents' insecurity, they don't want to send their girls, the daughters too far. It could be, yes, about the thinking of a society. Now they're not very comfortable in sending their daughters to school, right? Yes, so why do you think the children, they drop out from school? If boys are dropping out from school, what could be the reason for a dropout? Yes, so they feel, yes, absolutely correct here, that the girls, they should be involved in household work. And what about boys? They start helping in the fields, they start working in factories and shops, and they feel that, yes, so they are working and they are adding to the family income. So what's the need of sending them to school? isn't it? Right? Now here, as I said, we have seen these statistics. We have analyzed it. We've tried to understand what is this about, right? What is this graph trying to show us? I am going to give my observations also. But remember, our focus, it has to be more on the information that is provided. Okay, if don't start writing about why girls are not sent to school and why boys go to school more. No, don't shift your paragraph towards that. What has to be the focus of your paragraph? The focus of your paragraph has to be on the dropout rate of school, like of the students from the schools, right? That is what you have to focus on. And yes, so for that you can give that it could be because of lack of, you know, the nearby schools there, the lack of transportation, the parents' sense of insecurity, the unwillingness to send their children quite far, right? Yes, so all this here, and yes, the observation, right? Of course, that you can see that the boys drop out, it decreased there, but, and you can see this could be that, the growing awareness about education, which made the parents send their children to school. Okay, so if I share this information with you, if I share this graph with you, will you be able to write a paragraph on it? So what are the things you have to remember? Any writing skill that you have to do, please give a heading to it. Okay, the heading can be related to what the information is. Discuss the statistics. You have one graph showing about the girls, you have one graph showing about the boys. Discuss the rise, discuss the fall, right? Then discuss about the boys here, or if you like about the rise here, then the fall here, right? Which is there, what is more, you know, like apparent from this, the positive thing, that it has become steady, it is decreasing. What can be your conclusions? What can be your observations? Why there is a dropout rate? Yes, and of course here, how the decrease in the dropout rate is a good thing. It's a good thing. That means more students are now going to school. Parents are now sending their children to school. That will help in the development of our country. That will help in increasing the literacy rate. Okay, so this is one way in which you will, yes, Shantanu has understood. What about the others? Can I have a yes or a no from you all? Is it clear? Yeah, very nice. Very good. Yes. So good. Good. Yeah. Mehul, Amritpal, everybody's understood. Yes, Harshita has understood. That's nice. But I want you to write it in your notebook. Earlier also, I sent a couple of pictures, right? So please practice. This is a very, very important writing skill, which is definitely going to be asked. In all your tests, it is going to be there. In your final exams, it is going to be there. I might ask multiple choice questions, right? If, what does a data interpretation, a paragraph on data interpretation, what does it discuss? Right? So I can give choices regarding that. Yes? So you can get questions like that only. So don't worry that how will we get MCQs from writing the skills. We'll find a way for it. Don't worry. Okay? Now it's time to look at another picture, right? So let's see here. Is this visible? Is this picture visible? Yes? Is this visible? No? It is not visible? Wait. It is visible. Raghav is saying it is visible. Who's saying it is not visible? It is visible. So you made me stop sharing the screen. Right. Let me just share it once again. Take a quick look at it. Yes, here it is. Now, can you see? Yes. What is the picture about? So you can get, yeah, it was visible earlier also. Okay, now I'm getting a big yes from all of you. That's nice. It was visible earlier also. So please don't confuse the teacher. Now here, this is also a picture. It is a visual input, very, very clear, very easy ideas have been given, and you are to write a paragraph on it. Right? This is not data interpretation. This is simple, you know, like what facts which are given to you, right? And you have to expand this into a paragraph, okay? So one like we done earlier, it was about your graphs, and I'll be sharing that picture with you. I have shared many images with you over these past months. Now, this one is a simple paragraph writing here. A picture has been given and you have to write about it. What is the picture telling us about? It is telling us about road safety. What are we going to do? We are going to write a paragraph using these hints. Isn't it easy? Yes, it is very, very simple. It is very, very easy. Right? So we have to, one thing here, please, you know, like here, some lines you might pick up directly, but try to interpret it and try to rewrite it in your own way. Right? Fine. So yes, here it is, like road safety. Why is it important to be safe on the road? Because we have noticed that the number of road accidents are increasing every year. And why are they increasing? Because people don't obey the traffic rules. They break the rules and it results in a lot of losses. It results in deaths, right? And yes, so it is very dangerous here. So some of the problems, yes, it could be the bad roads are there. It could be because of bad weather. Right, it could be because someone was recklessly driving on the road, trying to overtake from the wrong side, right? All these things here. But some of the things which we always, always need to follow to be safe on the road. Can we write down what are these points that we need to follow to be always safe on the road? One is here, yes. Quit alcohol and mobile phones. Very dangerous combination. You're not supposed to be on the road if you are drunk. Do not use your mobile phone while driving. So even a polite message here, or you have there, right? Don't receive that, or you can always put it there that I'll call you later, right? Or that way. Do not exceed the speed limit. So speed limits are there mentioned along the highway. Everywhere, this is the limit you have to be. So try to be in that speed limit. Always remember to wear a seat belt. So, right? So you can, you know, like, of course, I've written here, you can give a little more input from your side also, I guess. So it is very dangerous to use the mobile because a little distraction on the phone, it can result in a major accident. Once again, do not exceed the speed limits. If speed limits are mentioned on the highways, we need to follow them. Overspeeding might result in hitting vehicles in front of us, or it might cause a major mishap. So seat belt, we must always wear for our safety, and all the passengers, right, who are there, they should also wear for their safety, right? Because yes, so we've noticed that many accidents, they were not so fatal because the people had worn safety belts. So slow down on wet roads and in bad weather. So don't think that, okay, I have to be a superhero on the roads when it is raining. No, we have to be sensible at all times, whether it is good weather, whether it is bad weather. And sometimes during the wet weather, what happens? Yes, the roads become slippery. There are patches of road with mud, it could be a mud stretch. So you have to slow down. Otherwise, you might get out of control and yes, skid off the road. Always obey all traffic rules and regulations. So you have to obey the traffic rules. You have to obey the rules and regulations. Naturally, if there is a red light, you should stop. Right? So if traffic lights are there, they're meant to be followed. You must obey those rules. And sometimes we feel, oh no, it's a red light. There's no vehicle. I can easily jump this light. No, a few seconds will not change your life. Okay. But yes, a few seconds of rash driving might change it. So we need to be very, very careful. Okay. Always be cautious and patient. So you have to be very patient. If you're in a traffic jam, please don't keep on honking your horn, right? And if there are a few vehicles in front of you, they're not going to move faster. You're not going to fly over them. They'll be on the road. They're going to take the time. Pay attention to the road. Yes, be very, very cautious. Look at the road ahead of you. Look around for, you know, pedestrians, people who are walking on the road sometimes. You know, like, yeah, they have every right to be on the road, and you have to be responsible to be slow and cautious. Yes, and do not panic, remain calm and composed. Okay, so here this would be, I would say, do you agree this would be one of the easiest kinds of paragraph to write? So this is also, yeah, this is information which is given to you. You're given information like this and you have to just write a paragraph on it, right? So please here, once again, try to add your information also. Give a proper heading. Give a conclusion, right? Yes, so the conclusion is that, yeah, we have to be cautious on the road always. Only then we can prevent or decrease the number of road accidents that are happening every day. Is this clear to you all? Is it clear? Yes. Oh, yes, right. I've got some wonderful ideas from the students. And right. So, yes, the traffic is increasing every day. So that is why there are so many road accidents. People are not sensible on the roads. People are careless on the roads. And right. We have youngsters with vehicles and they drive very, very recklessly. Okay. Right. Clear? So what are the things that you have to remember? You, for your writing skills, this is your JET interpretation, your bar graph, your pie chart, your statistics, any kind. You have to look at it. You have to interpret it. You might get a visual input like I have given you. So writing, the understanding, the information which is given to you. That was easy? Yes? If you get that kind of a picture, will you be able to write a paragraph on it? Give me a yes. Yeah, that's nice. Very nice. So we will all be able to write a paragraph on that. Okay, right.